Hi, I'm Elliot, and in this epic tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to master Not Boring Camera, the most fun and unique camera app I've ever used on the iPhone. In fact, I'm such a huge fan of this app, I've developed the Epic Boring Film Look Pack that delivers stunning film emulations for SuperRAW in Not Boring Camera, and you can check the link in the description. Now let's dive in and learn how to master the best camera app ever made for the iPhone. Let's start with a fresh launch of Not Boring Camera after downloading it from the App Store, where we get to build our camera. Start by granting camera access and then allow full access to the photos library. Lastly, if you want to capture geolocation, enable location access while using the app. Now we can pick our colorway, which is a custom skin for our camera. Don't agonize over your choice too much, as we will fully customize this later. For now, I'll choose retro and tap build. Now it's time to pick up our camera and have some fun. Let's begin with an overview of the interface, starting with the gloriously large shutter button. Tap to take a photo, complete with rich haptic feedback. It will be saved to photos and shown in the viewfinder for 2 seconds, giving you an opportunity to review, delete, or share directly within Not Boring Camera. If you want to dismiss the photo review, just tap the shutter button again to return instantly to the viewfinder, which occupies the center of the interface. Tap anywhere to set a conjoined focus and exposure point of interest, just like in the Apple Camera app. Above the shutter button is the exposure control wheel. In auto mode, which we are currently in as signified by the auto mode icon in the lower left, it will act as an EV offset slider, allowing us to brighten or darken our image. Our EV offset value is displayed in the lower left of the viewfinder. Auto exposure continues to operate just with a negative or positive exposure bias. To reset exposure offset to zero, you can tap the offset value in the viewfinder. Beneath the shutter button is our lens picker, giving you quick access to your ultra-wide, 1x, 5x, and selfie cameras. You can either slide and release or tap to jump immediately to your desired lens. In the upper left, we can turn on the flash. Taking a photo with this on delivers the greatest haptic event in iPhone history. Beneath it is the styles picker, allowing you to quickly cycle through Not Boring Camera's real-time styles, which are LUTs, short for lookup table in .cube format, for some really beautiful film looks which are applied in camera, giving you stunning photos that are instantly ready to share. Later you'll learn how to import your own styles, as well as edit which styles are shown and which are hidden. Beneath the styles picker is the mode button, which lets you toggle between auto and manual modes. And to the left of this is the settings button, which we will delve into shortly. Now let's learn how to use the manual mode, which gives us complete control over shutter speed, ISO, and white balance by tapping on the mode button. When the shutter, ISO, and white balance values are surrounded by a white border, it means they are unlocked and operating automatically. Let's tap on ISO and set it manually with the exposure control wheel. As we drag, zebras are displayed in the viewfinder, indicating overexposure in red and underexposure in blue. We also reveal the histogram in the viewfinder during manual adjustments, which again will display shadow clipping in blue and highlight clipping in red. To disable the histogram and zebras, tap the histogram. Tap again to enable. Next, we can tap the shutter speed value and adjust it with the exposure control wheel. And lastly, we can do the same for white balance. Tap to select it, then use the exposure control wheel to manually set your Kelvin value. To unlock a manual control, just tap on it in the viewfinder so it turns white and it will respond automatically again. And you can, of course, just tap on the exposure mode button to instantly reset all values to auto. To adjust your focus manually, just tap, hold, and swipe up and down in landscape and left and right in portrait. This reveals a focus loop complete with focus peaking to make nailing your focus an absolute breeze. To reset focus to auto, just tap anywhere in the viewfinder. Now let's dive into the settings menu, which currently only presents in portrait orientation. tap on the settings button, and here we can access Customise, Styles, Capture, and Control settings, a user guide, and a feature I absolutely love is the Stats section, which will give you insights into your shutter count, camera streak, and most used style. Let's return to the top of settings and start with Customise, which allows us to customize our camera skin, complete with soothing background music. Start by selecting your body color using any of the color presets. If your desired color isn't available, tap on the color picker icon and use grid, spectrum, or sliders to find the perfect color. I'll return and choose black. Next, select your top, lens, button, dial, shutter, and exposure colors. And what is insanely cool is that you can share your camera skin with a friend or second device. Just tap to export a QR code. I'll save it to the Photos app. Then, on my second iPhone, I can use Not Boring Camera to scan it, and voila, I've imported my skin. In fact, if you'd like my epic skin for Not Boring Camera, simply scan this code right now to import it. I'll return to the app and tap Done to accept. And the attention to detail in this app is just phenomenal. If I adjust focus manually, the color reflects the lens color I just picked. Next, let's return to settings and look at styles, which is probably the app's most powerful feature. First of all, you can see all the styles listed in the order you will cycle through them using the styles picker in the main camera interface. If you find that there are some styles you just never use, you can tap the eye icon to hide them, which will remove them from the styles picker. I might hide burn and black and chrome. We can also reorder the styles. For example, I'll tap edit and then drag to reposition 0, which applies zero processing to the image and presents what is captured by the raw sensor to the very top of our styles list. Let's tap on done and swipe down to close settings. Now you can see that 0 is the first style and burn and chrome are missing. A Not Boring Camera has a few additional style tricks up its sleeve. Let's return to settings, styles. If you tap on a style, it will give you a description of the look as well as an intensity slider so you can mix the style or LUT with the original raw image as it comes from the sensor. You even get a preview of the effect the intensity slider has on the sample images. Lastly, let's look at importing a custom LUT into Not Boring Camera, which really opens up a world of creative possibilities for photographers. Not Boring Camera accepts .cube LUTs at 33 point size. Just tap on Import a LUT, then navigate to a location on your iOS device using the Files app and select your custom LUT. You can give a name if it isn't already included in the LUT and adjust the intensity if required, then tap Done. Return to Styles and you can reposition as required. I'll import the rest of my custom LUTs one by one as batch importing isn't currently supported and swipe down to dismiss settings. Now I can apply my custom LUTs via the Styles picker and take unique photos that look absolutely gorgeous. And if you want the ultimate film looks for Not Boring Camera, you can save 20% off the Epic Boring Film Look Pack with the special code in the description, which contains a collection of film looks painstakingly designed for Not Boring Camera's SuperRAW image processing. And speaking of SuperRAW, let's return to settings and look at the capture options. Under processing, you get three choices. SuperRAW, which is built off the native RAW sensor data, delivering the most organic film grain, zero processing and fast capture speed. It applies your selected style to the bare RAW, then saves the photo as a high-quality HEIF image. ProRAW, which is Apple's own high-quality RAW format, which applies a range of computational processes, resulting in a less organic and more over-processed look. However, it does deliver the highest resolution, largest file size, at the slowest capture speed. And Basic, which delivers standard quality via Apple's default image processing with little to no grain. For best results, I'd recommend capturing in SuperRAW, which is what the styles in Not Boring Camera are designed against and is the antidote to the computational overprocessing that defines smartphone photography today. Beneath this, you can enable three levels of HDR or leave this off. I don't like any extra processing and always leave this off. and under resolution you can choose between standard resolution or max, which will deliver up to 48 megapixels if supported on your wide or ultra-wide lenses in ProRAW or basic processing modes, but as SuperRAW is limited to the native resolution of 12 megapixel only, I'll leave this set to standard as I do not use ProRAW or basic processing. Below this we can enable Save RAW Copy, which will save a DNG RAW image alongside your processed SuperRAW HEIF. Ideal if you want complete flexibility to edit your image in post, I like to turn this on for important shoots. And lastly, we can embed location data or disable geotagging. Lastly, let's look at the camera control settings. First is photo review, which is set to a 2-second review after each capture by default. If you want to disable this completely, you can set this to off, or choose 2, 5, or 10 seconds. Remember, you can return to the camera view instantly during review by tapping the shutter button. I like this at the default 2 seconds. Next, you can disable or enable sounds and haptics. For me, both of these make Not Boring Camera the incredible app it is, so I'll leave them on. But if shooting a concert or a performance, you'll probably want to kill the sound to avoid distracting an audience, for example. And you can decide whether you want to use the hardware buttons, including volume and camera control, to act as shutter buttons or not. I turn this on. Lastly, we have our compose tools, including a rule of thirds guide and a level meter, which can be enabled or disabled here. If you're anything like me, you'll want to set Not Boring Camera as your camera app default. Let's do this on the lock screen. Just long press on it and choose Customise. Then tap on lock screen, remove the native camera app, and tap the plus. Not Boring Camera can be found by searching for an exclamation mark and tapping to add it, then tap done. If your iPhone features the camera control button, you can map Not Boring Camera to it by opening Settings, Camera, Camera Control, Launch Camera, and selecting it from here. Now double-clicking the camera control button will launch Not Boring Camera. And if you'd like to map it to your action button, just open Settings, Action button, choose Shortcut, choose a shortcut, open App, and select Not Boring Camera here. Tap and hold the action button to launch Not Boring Camera. Now that you've mastered everything this app has to offer, I think we can all agree that this is as far from boring as camera apps get, and it makes taking photos fun. I hope this tutorial helped you get the most out of this incredible app. If it did, please like and subscribe to the channel, and check out the Epic Boring Film Look Pack for the ultimate collection of styles for super raw photos in Not Boring Camera. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.